having troubles going from this to this. Your animation is finished. You have everything done. Composition checks. Lighting checked. Materials checked. Now you want to render your animation, but wait, you have no idea how to set up your render settings. Let's fix this today. Render settings are not a big deal. Remember that this is not what makes your animations look fantastic. This helps you in optimizing the time of rendering, for instance. I will show you two render methods. The first one is longer, but also more precise. So it will work well when you have, for example, lots of moving objects in the scene. This will prevent flickering. So as we're doing animation in V-Ray, let's make sure we have V-Ray selected as render. The next thing is the time output. As I have the time configuration adjusted to the camera movement, I can choose the active time segment option. Let me show you the shot I'm going to render. You can see it takes 56 frames, exactly like my active time segment. Anyway, of course, you need to set the correct output size. Now we can go to the V-Ray tab and we can set the image sampler to bucket. And of course, for the final rendering, we need to set the smaller amount of the noise threshold. I will start with 0.005, but you always should test it first, as sometimes the image is more demanding, another time you don't need as low value. Now we can use brute force in animations, which is a very accurate method and it doesn't cause flickering. However, I will use Irradiance map in this case, as I want to show you the quickest way of rendering animation. I always set up the minimum rate to -4 and -2 as the max rate. Here you can adjust these values. A higher value of subdivision produces a smoother image, so you can increase it up to 80, for instance. For the light cache, you can leave it as it is. Eventually, you can increase the number of subdivisions. Higher values decrease flickering. In the settings, I will increase the post-fx rate to the maximum value. This is responsible for the frequency of post-fx updates, such as denoising and lens effects. Next, add all needed render elements. I will add V-Ray denoiser, but you will probably want to add more. If you want to learn more about render elements, watch my video on this topic. I put the link in the corner. In the end, we need to set the path where we want our frames to be saved. We can use 3ds Max render output here. We need to check save file and add a correct path by clicking files. Always name your shots in the way that it's pretty straightforward. I always use OpenAXR 16-bit channel and click the render button. And now let the hardware do the thing. Depending on your computer's parameters, the speed of rendering will vary. Talking about render speed, RenderFarm is the sponsor of this video. They are the render farm we use if we need to render quickly and we don't have time to use our computers. They are perfect for RVs artists because they support all the popular software, but most importantly, they have all the plugins we need, so there won't be any unpleasant surprises. They've created a software plugin, so everything can be set up in your application, 3ds Max in my case. It checks the scene and automatically uploads it to the farm, and after rendering it's done, it downloads everything to your local folder. There are no hidden costs. You know how much you will pay for every render if you use their cost estimation tool. They're also great people. They're always there if we need something. They have 24/7 human support. And the best part is that you can get started with their free trial. I will put the link to their website in the corner and in the description below, so you can check them out and sign up for your free trial. Okay. Let's go back to the settings. I will show you another method that is faster and works well if there is no moving objects in the scene. This method is based on two stages. The first is pre-calculating the irradiance map and light cache, and the second is using these files to render the final frames. Sounds complicated? Don't worry, we'll eat the elephant one bite at a time. So let me show you the trick. The idea here is that we don't need to render each frame for pre-calculation purposes, but every 20th, 5th or 10th, etc. Depending on the scene. For the exterior, every 20th 5th should be more than enough. Then you go to global switches, click here to get more options. We don't want to render the final image to save time. Besides, we don't need it in this step. Next, go to the irradiance map and change single mode to multi-frame incremental. This mode is useful in such a situation as ours. So when we want to render a sequence of frames, not necessarily consecutive, where only the camera moves around, so-called fly-through animations. With this mode, Rig computes a new full image irradiance map for the first rendered frame, while for all other frames, Fury tries to reuse and refine the irradiance map that has been computed so far to make the process faster. Again, click on the default to get more options. At the bottom, you will see the place where we can save the file. Check autosave and select the correct path. I will save it in the camera folder. Then go to Light Cache. Choose animation so it will automatically change the settings for you. Click autosave and choose the correct path for the Light Cache file. Other settings can stay the same as before. Similarly, for render elements. And we can hit the render button now and wait for the files to be prepared. This is a warning that we don't have render output from 3ds Max checked. We don't have to worry about it as we used Vue options to save files. You can see that 6 frames will be calculated in the total. Thanks to this technique, we can optimize the time of rendering. So to sum up, we pre-calculate the irradiance map and light cache without rendering the final output. Let me show you. You can notice that after prepass 3, there is no rendering image stage as it normally is. The next frame starts to be computed straight away. Now, after computing is finished, you'll find the files in the selected folder. Okay, now we can move forward to the second stage. Now we will render the whole animation sequence, so we need to render each frame. You can use one of the saving methods I've shown you before. So you can choose the path here, but I will use Vue frame buffer this time. Check the separate render channels option. Name the frames and choose the open XR file format. 16 bits channel. Okay, in this case, we need to uncheck this option as we want to render the final image now. We can also check this option so it will save the VFB color correction to render elements. Now change the mode to from file and choose the proper file. In my case, it will be irradiance map. The same for the light cache. Choose the from file option and choose the file. The rest stays as it was before. We can click render now. Here we go. You can see that all the selected frames will be rendered. Another thing you may notice is that after updating all objects and preparing from V-Ray, we go straight to the rendering image process. There is no building light cache prepasses, etc. You can imagine how much time we save thanks to this. During the rendering, all the frames and chosen render elements will be progressively saved in the selected folder. Now, we need to wait for all the files to be rendered and ready to combine into one video. To learn more about animations, download our free ebook. Also, watch my other videos on this topic. Here are my suggestions. Bye bye!